Many patients come to me with recurrent nosebleeds, along with internal problems and medicinal side effects. The most frequent cause is a harmless change affecting the mucous membranes of the nose. These have superficial blood vessels that repeatedly burst, resulting in nosebleeds. In such cases, Silverin Silver Nitrate Sticks are an ideal treatment option. These caustic sticks are very simple to use, and complications are unlikely if certain basic rules are followed. Always only treat one side at a time and wait 4 weeks before starting with the second nostril. With children, only the 50% Silverin stick should be used. For adults, the 75% sticks are more suitable. In the ear, nose and throat region, I only use the elastic sticks because they're smaller, gentler in use, and intended for application at discrete points. The rigid sticks are more suitable for treating larger areas, in wound management, for example. The benefit of treatment with silver nitrate sticks is that they target the surface of the mucous membranes without their action going too deep, i.e., without reaching the underlying cartilage. This means damage to the cartilage beneath is extremely unlikely. Treatment begins with the insertion of a piece of cotton wool soaked in roughly equal amounts of a local anesthetic and decongestant nose drops. For this purpose, I use 10% lidocaine, in this case, xylocaine spray, and also Rinon nasal spray, which is an aphazoline-based solution. Once the cotton wool has been applied to Kieselbach's plexus or the affected mucosal area, it's left in place for about 2 minutes to take effect. An important point is, with children, I always first apply a 1% procaine derivative. In this case, 1% binoxonate, because lidocaine causes irritation of the mucous membranes. Children don't feel this. There is no burning sensation on the mucous membranes, and it doesn't adversely affect compliance. As with adults, this is mixed with Rinin spray and allowed to take effect for 2 minutes before being removed. Xylocaine is then applied. This has the advantage of ensuring the local anesthetic takes full effect, and you then have ample time to use the stick to cauterize the blood vessel. After the cotton wool has been removed, the stick is briefly dipped in water to moisten the tip. Water is important because, for example, saline solutions may absorb the silver nitrate and thus compromise its action. The water droplet that remains on the tip must be wiped away. After that, the stick is applied at the precise site of the vessel, using gentle pressure. The stick is left in contact with the mucosa for about 3 seconds, and then removed with a slightly rolling motion. In this case, I use it at 3 different points, and do it exactly the same at each point. Excess caustic material, which would otherwise be transported posteriorly via the mucous membranes and end up where it doesn't belong, can be simply but carefully wiped away using a cotton swab. The treatment procedure is now complete. If the patient has acute bleeding from the nose, I use this method with the procedural steps in the same order. So, the cotton wool is again applied to the bleed site. What you can also do is apply manual compression and wait until the vasoconstructive substances take effect. After removal, you can expect this area and cauterize the vessel with the sticks. This works in most cases, and you can repeat the treatment. After about a month, this treatment also can be carried out on the other side. Treating both nostrils at the same time is not advisable because of the risk of perforating the septum, since the mucous membrane feeds the cartilage underneath.